Hi, my name is Jim Durr, and I'm an application support engineer for Agilent Technologies. A common question I get regarding the 53200 series counter is its ability to measure consecutive cycles from an input pulse stream. And what I'm going to demonstrate is how we can do that. The answer is, when asked that question, can we measure consecutive cycles? The answer is really yes and no. And let me demonstrate by what I mean. What I've done is I've preloaded a burst sequence from the 53500 series function generator. And what this function generator is going to do is going to output a burst of 10 pulses. And what we're going to do is attempt to measure those 10 pulses using two different modes of the counter. So again, with the function generator preloaded, using the front panel host port of the counter, I'm going to go ahead and take advantage of the ability to load a pre-saved or a pre-stored state that will set this up for the measurement. So in doing so, I simply insert the thumb drive and I shall recall the state. Okay, so I've got the counter preloaded with the state ready to make the measurement. The first measurement I'm going to make involves using the counter within the auto mode. By auto mode, first I will set the auto mode. By auto mode, that implies to how the gate of the measurement is handled with the counter. And what we mean by that is within auto mode is there is a gate open, gate closed sequence for each measurement in my reading count. So for example, the gate opens, the trigger comes in, the gate opens, I begin the measurement, the gate closes, I complete the measurement. The next trigger comes in, I open the gate, make the measurement, gate measurement is done, I close the gate, and so on. In continuous mode, which is the second of the two modes that I'm going to demonstrate, what happens is there's a gate open at the very beginning. Once a trigger is received, there is a gate open for the first reading. The gate remains open for each subsequent reading and then closes once all readings are taken. What that does is that eliminates the gap in between consecutive readings and allows us to measure consecutive input cycles. So with having said that, I will go ahead and I will press the trigger to input or a couple things first. The first thing when making any type of measurements, especially measurements that are slow, the signal that I'm measuring has a 2 second period. Something that's overlooked but is very important is to set the measurement timeout. The measurement timeout is the period that we allow the counter to make the measurement before timing out and continuing with the next measurement. So a good check and something to always note is when storing or recalling a state, the measurement timeout setting is not preserved in your stored state. So you want to be sure that you're able to check that setting. So very quickly, before this, I check utility, instrument setup, timeout settings, and as you can see, I have turned timeout off. This will give us an indefinite amount of time for the measurements to complete. So with that set, I am then going to go to the graph mode, and I'm going to enable the trend chart feature of the counter. With the trend chart enabled, I'm going to go ahead and press the trigger key. Once I press the trigger key, I will go ahead and start inputting in a series of 10 input cycles to the counter. One thing that I wanted to point out as well is I'm externally triggering the counter from the function generator. So when I press the trigger key on the function generator to trigger the output, the function generator in turn is triggering the counter. So now I'm going to go ahead and press trigger to input the signal into the counter. And what you're going to notice is there's a momentary delay as the counter is requiring a certain number of cycles at the beginning in order to establish the measurement. You can see now the first reading of approximately 2 seconds has occurred. Our reading count is 1. And as we continue on, we wait for the next number of cycles to occur, and our reading count is 2. Now keep in mind that what we have done is we have programmed the function generator to give us 10 cycles. We are in the auto mode of the counter. Auto mode again, there is an open and close gate sequence for each reading. What is happening is for all these cycles, for each gate sequence, there's an additional number of cycles that are required in order to produce the reading. As a result, we've only been able to take within auto mode 2 measurements of the 10 cycles that were coming in. To alleviate that, we switch to continuous mode, where as I had described it before, we have 1 gate open and 1 gate closed sequence, and all of our trait readings are taking in succession in the middle. So to show that, I will go back and I will change the reading mode from auto to continuous. Okay, now that we have seen the number of readings taken within auto mode, I'm going to go ahead, or I've changed the configuration to continuous mode. I'm going to trigger the function generator. And again, you will notice in a moment the readings will continue to occur in continuous mode. We've established our first reading, and now what you are seeing is we've already exceeded our two readings. We are now up at five readings, and we will go to continue to about seven readings. Now still, or eight readings rather, still this is not the point of the 10 readings that we hope to accomplish, but what we were able to see is within auto mode we only were able to achieve two readings. Here we have been able to achieve up to eight readings. And the reason why was the first number of signals, or the first couple of cycles were required to establish the first reading, two cycles in this instance, leaving us two readings remaining to complete our total of 10 readings. So to alleviate that, I can go back to the function generator and I can set the number of cycles. I will set it to a number larger than 10 to account for the number of cycles that are required to establish the first reading. So now I have set the number of cycles to 13. I will clear my readings, reading storage. I will preset. I will recall my state to make sure that everything is clear and initialized. Again, I'm in continuous mode. Now I've got 13 cycles programmed to come into the counter, and my counter is expecting to measure 10 cycles consecutively. I will go ahead again, turn on the graph, the trend chart, trigger the counter. And momentarily, you will see the first reading begin. There's reading one. And then at every 2 second intervals, you'll see my reading count continues. And 10. And there, you can see I've completed the full 10 readings that I was expecting to measure. What I had to account for was the fact that on the first reading, it requires multiple cycles of the input signal in order to produce the first reading. Once that first reading is taken, then in continuous mode, within one continuous gate open-close sequence, I'm able to go ahead and take successive readings back to back to back on each of the 10 cycles. So although the function generator output 13 cycles, the first 3 cycles were required for the first reading, I was then able to pick up consecutively the remaining 10 cycles, as is indicated by my reading count shown on the display. Thank you.